today's video is going to be about blossom end rot. It's a very common thing that happens to our fruits and vegetables during this time of the year. Basically what that is, it's going to be for the most part a calcium deficiency, that your plant is not getting enough calcium, the fertilizer isn't providing enough calcium. That's going to be the most common reason for blossom end rot. Some other reasons why this could be happening to your plant are that there are too many fluctuations in the moisture levels of your watering schedule with the plant. You don't want it to let it get too dry, and you don't want it to be too wet and kind of go back and forth on that watering schedule. That could cause blossom end rot in your plant. Another way is that if your plant's root system was damaged, that could also kind of trigger blossom end rot in your plant, as well as there being too much nitrogen in your soil, that could also cause it. So what it does basically is it's going to rot your plant from the very bottom, and it'll develop like a little black circle of rotty flesh of your vegetable or your fruit, and it'll just keep doing that to all of your fruit. Once that happens to your fruit, it doesn't repair itself. If you use something to, you know, repair it, it's not going to do anything to the damaged fruit already. So what you're going to want to do is remove the fruit and start fertilizing with something that's providing it more calcium. You want to give your plants a nice fertilizer that provides the phosphorus for blooming and fruiting, and also contains calcium. If you have a fertilizer that does not have calcium in it, you're going to want to fertilize with something that does have more calcium. So we do have options like the age-old calcium. It's going to be a 20% amount of calcium. This is quite a bit. It's a concentrate that you can just dilute in your watering can. Water your plants that have it or don't have it even, and then it'll protect them and create new fresh fruit that is not rotting from the bottom. So another thing that you can also use is a spray that we have specifically for blossom end rot. So you'll just apply this when you start noticing your blossom end rot. The same thing, you want to remove, you know, the damaged fruit and the damaged parts of the plants so that it can start repairing itself and putting energy into new fruit and new blooms. So you want to be on top of that, or else you're going to notice a very big decline in your plants once they do have blossom end rot. So on our hotter days, be sure that you're keeping up with your watering schedule. You may have to be watering once to twice every single day. Keep the watering schedules consistent. Try to be outside and monitoring how much moisture is in your soil, as well as what your fruit and blooms and foliage look like. Make sure everything looks healthy. And then if you do start noticing blossom end rot, it's not the end of the world. It's not the end of your plant. Just remove that fruit and start providing it a fertilizer with the calcium and the phosphorus. So that's going to be the best tips for blossom end rot and how to get rid of it. So thank you for watching this video today. If you have any questions about blossom end rot or any other plant questions, we are more than happy to answer them.